Hello boys and girls. In this video I finally get around going through a curated list that I have assembled on in mostly introductory category theory texts. I also link to a logician's curated list of introductory material, so that's books mostly, some lecture notes. Most of them are available online, so if they are on archive or on some university hosted sites, then I just link directly through to them. Otherwise I will quickly show you the Amazon page so you can see the name. The list is in the description box, so I posted the list on Gist from GitHub, and there's also the link to these other lists. In total it's like 50 books or so, and I will go through 20 of them. I will shortly comment on them roughly in order of relevance as I see it. So obviously there are a few angles, and there are a few different fractions of people who are interested in category theory initially, like in the 40s, like 70, 80 years ago. These concepts were conceptualized more in the algebraic topology corner, then swept over to algebraic geometry, then logic, then you have stuff like topos theory, and more recently computer science, and even more recently like even you would say practical programming tasks are infiltrated a little bit by category theoretical notions, especially initially with Haskell. But you know, many things that Haskell did also know you find in other languages. So if you get to this video, then I don't know which fraction you come of, what your interest angle is. Personally, my angle to category theory was initially more through the logic angle, so understanding Enla post by physicists talking about topos theory. That was the things I found most interesting. Obviously, like now, just for some basic introductory comment, it helps a lot if you also know many examples. A lot of examples come especially from algebraic geometry, which I'm not strong in, or general algebra, topology. And there's also current different direction which that goes. I mean, there's a lot of funny debate. The title here is taken from some angry trolls that make fun of people who just learn basic category theory without having any angle to the use cases and learn it on its own. I think it's fun and interesting to learn topos theory just for its own, if you just know some logic and see this language translated in some other framework. And I guess a similar thing goes for the computer science minded people. But nonetheless, I mean, it's a meme, but also it's a meme because it's not really a meme. If you want to understand contemporary like research, like to say some buzzwords, if you want to watch a YouTube video on Scholz's work on periodic analysis or whatnot, then you need the language, even if you don't go too deep into the, you know, just category theoretical aspects of it. Okay, but I'm ranting here. And this was just as a motivation. I go mostly about books that just introduce category theory directly. Then some topical things that I mentioned just because I saw them and I liked them. The things I read and I didn't like did not make it into this video. There's nothing about higher category theory, I think. And there's also, as I said, no strong connection to algebraic geometry, simply because that's not my strongest field here. Okay, I just start with this. This is German, but there's this popular image where it says, attention, functor, keep distance of 2 meters. So for people who have no idea about category theory, since there are different fractions and people have different angles, it's almost dangerous to say anything, but from a very raw angle, it's certainly a theory about associative concatenation of some abstract errors. And as a theory, like if you just have like basic category theory, no higher categories, no particular extra structure on categories, like if you don't consider interesting products or properties of the home classes, then category theory is a pretty empty, in a way, subject. So there's a few lemmas, but unless you take a category of your interest and refine properties, you cannot say all that much about just category theory on its own. So I would say it's something you can quickly learn. Nonetheless, there are books written from different angles, and the selection out of, like, I will go through a bunch of books linked to this other guy's site. There will be 40 or 50 books. The ones I have selected are selected by the following criteria. Either I just like the book, or I just have to include it because it's a classic, or it's a book that if I don't include it, some people will get angry with me. So these are the prime criteria. As I mentioned, some books are in there just because they're, I think, good entry points to particular fields. And finally, some books are mentioned simply because they kind of tie to the content that I provide here on this YouTube channel. Okay, so the link where I put the first 25 or so books is here on this gist. You will find the link to this in the comments below. And also, as I said, there is this page called Logic Matters by Peter Smith, and this is a logician, an academic, and on this website you actually find much more. He has 120 or so page essay or text that discusses different angles to start with logic. So he's curated the kind of, if you're this type of person, then you might want to read this book, or if you're interested in this and that topic, then you might want to read that. And he has book reviews, especially on logic, on his page. And as I understand it, a few years ago, he also started to learn category theory. And so one of these sub pages on his website is a list of online available category theory books. So a lot of those I will also come across in this video. So this is the one first link. If you Google reading list for category theory, you will also come across people uploading, like I just did on GitHub, some reading lists. The stuff you find there is probably curated mostly by computer science people. I also include in the list a few books that are tailored for physicists, computer scientists, and so on and so forth. Not necessarily because I think they are particularly good books, but you know, I cannot judge if you come from that angle, if those books might not be a better introduction than a pure math introduction tailored for mathematics students. Okay, so the first book I want to talk about, the first four or so books that I mentioned are books I like, and in a sense I feel it's easiest if you read them together in a way, right? So this first book I really liked when I discovered it a few years ago. This is a book, as you see, 400 something pages, and this introduces category theory on a very raw kind of way. It has examples, but it's not very focused on the examples, and it doesn't go very deep with the individual examples. So it's sort of, to one extent, it sort of presumes that you already know the examples. But why I really like this book is that it's very picture heavy, and in an abstract sense, it almost looks like a graph theory book in that way. And so I'm not sure to what extent this is if you just read this book on its own, how good your understanding becomes. So that's why I'm saying I really like this book, but I also think this should be supported by some other book that you read maybe at the same time or shortly afterwards, or so on and so forth. And always talk with people, of course, who know more. I mean, by now there's interest groups and Discords and other forums where you can ask questions. Even if you're not like at university already. So I would definitely make use of that. This just really helped me, especially when this book discusses limits and inverse limits and so on and so forth. This helped me back in the day. So this is the first that I recommend in a way. And the next two are more classic. So there's this Leinster basic category theory book. I think this is very well written, and this guy, you also find he's more of his stuff and more of his opinions online. So this is one of the academic minded people who are also you find a bunch of some of those guys on Stack Overflow and so on and so forth. And this is not what I want to say. This is not the only text that you can read or learn from him and in this kind of style. So this is really I would say, straightforward, modern-minded introduction to category theory. And similarly, people like, and I would say this is the case, this book by Here you go. This is similar. I think he is more computer science minded. That's kind of probably. I mean, I don't know all the people too well personally, of course, and so I don't want to say anything wrong. But this is another good intro from that perspective. I would recommend picking one of those two and reading it together with looking up in other books. Nonetheless, there's different opinions, and I go through another much more slow going books as we go along. This is very different than the other books. There is this book called Topoi by Goldblatt. And when I got started many years ago on reading into these kind of things, I really like this one. So this is a kind of odd book in that. So this is geared towards categorical logic. And it takes 70, 80 pages, I think, just to introduce functors, which is strange, since essentially category theory was cooked up to introduce natural transformations for which functors were needed. And this is kind of the one of the fundamental building block of the whole theory. And this book really just takes its time, has nice graphics and graphs and the text. So despite this being about categorical logic, you don't have to read it past page 150. But this is just a very nice reading on the general concept. So this is similar the first book in a way that to get used to this kind of language. So this recommendation for that matter. So these were for the core books that I like. What comes up is the classic categories for the working mathematician. This is just reference that if you don't know anything about category theory might be somewhat steep, especially if you haven't done too much algebra before, if you're not a mathematician, but nonetheless it's quite clear and states theorems in strong forms pretty quickly. And so I would also recommend it, even though the other four books that I mentioned up to this point are easier to get into, in my opinion. Then follow some more straightforward introduction to category theory. I have not read all of them, but maybe I got recommended some of them, or maybe that's I saw that as a standard recommendation that people gave, so that's why I also include those in this text. So maybe if you, you know, the second and the third book that I discussed, by Leinster and if they are not for you, then maybe they are more suited. I will not, when I can maybe quickly slowly scroll through the table of content here. By the way, in the list that I posted below, I give the title, the name, the link that you see here, and also state how long these books are on their own. So for example, the McLean book, the categories for the working mathematician, is like 314 pages, as I've written down here. This is just a short book. Similarly, this is also like an introductory category theory book. Not going to discuss this much here. Similarly, this Barr and Wells book. I think these guys are more logically minded. For some reason, I associate them with monads, and so so much for that. Yeah, then the Steve Smith guy that I already pointed to, he also has written an introduction. So he learned that a few years ago himself, I suppose, and wrote his own introduction. He also has a book on Gödel's theorems, for one, where he like straight to the point on 300 pages or so explains this. I read it some years ago for just a pure interest. I liked his reading writing style for the most part, so I suppose this might also be a nice introduction worth looking into. So I assumed, on the one hand, this is especially for people who, like, I think he teaches logic at the philosophy department, but he's a like proper logician, and I suppose you will notice that from that angle in his writing as well. And I think that's probably also a nice one. Then I include a text. I think this is a quite short text of 60 pages by John Bass, simply because it's also popular. I expect a lot of people read that, and you might get this kind of recommendation. The guy famously, of course, also has this blog. I'm not sure if he still posts there. He's like one of the OG internet users from the 90s, and posted about math decades ago. And also, like, he was for a long time in the higher categories group, like, that you also find on the NLAB, Urschreiber, these kind of guys. So a physicist initially, although some people might not consider these guys physicists. Obviously, they will consider themselves physicists themselves as well. I mean, there's like me, probably a lot of people would consider me a sort of mathematician, despite myself. I consider myself a statistical physicist, but okay, so much for that. There's a bunch of books by Levier. I will not mention all of them. He has some introductory books to category theory, and then some other books. And he's like one of the Urschreiber, which I follow. It's a physicist on the NLAB who also has a very active Twitter, where he like promotes, I would say, or informs people of his stuff. And he's building a lot of his view on this guy who wanted to make the role of topos as more prominent, especially also with physics. So you have differential geometric angles to topos theory, or recasting differential geometry in this language, and goes in the direction of synthetic geometry. And Urs goes in this direction also, together with the people who are into higher category theory, or are tied to the computer science-y homotopy type theory angle, not to be confused with work of Lurie, who is like close to that thematically, but doesn't really work, as I understand, with the same people, who also does higher category theory, if you are already able to read that kind of stuff. Jacob Lurie has on his webpage, of course, also a bunch of books, which are famously probably challenging to get into. If you are able to read them, then you probably know about them anyway. Okay, so to say some words on the books by Lavier. So I think he has one or two books that are basically like he was really a strong proponent of the two-point approach to mathematics in general. So if you look at some of the other guys who use category theory, and especially the geometers, they of course use it just as a tool, I would say. And even if they like the framework, would not go as far as to say like drop you know, Zermelo, Frenkel set theory in general, and try to recast things in a category theoretical fashion. And if you look at these books, then he really does math from the start with categories. So I suppose in this book, I don't know how far he goes. If I remember this correctly, I might have read into that book, and I'm not sure if he gets... If it gets to the point where he can discuss joints in a strong detail, or maybe also confuse it with the other category book. But this is a peculiar way, like the Lavier approach. If you're like, the problem is if you already have learned mathematics from one angle, then it might be hard to get into that. I think this is like learning a musical instrument the wrong way, then learning it without knowing anything about it might be easier. I think with math it's a little bit similar. Okay, so let me carry on here. More introductory books to category theory directly. This is just a 80-page set of notes. And now to the more topical, like the books that are not just a raw introduction to category theory, let's say. This is an often recommended book that introduces basically algebra. This has the content of this is basically the general abstract algebra, as you would find it from some other text. But it uses category theory from the start, so very early on, yeah, characterizes, I don't know, injections and surjections with an emphasis on errors, and not just the algebraic manipulation as you have it commonly. Of introduction to algebras, to algebra. I think this is a pretty long. Yeah, it has over 700 pages. Especially if you're into algebra, obviously, then this might be a way to go to pick up category theory at the same time. I have not read it yet, but I came across recently this book on basically universal algebra emphasis. This is using category theory to do algebra, and has this like super strong focus on universal properties, which are like one of the nice things. Like the universal properties are, in a way, I would say the thing why category theory is aesthetically nicer or closer to real math than the set theory constructions, which are material. These are like the NLAB buzzwords. I don't want to get too much into it, but there's a difference, of course, in pulling up your mathematical objects from sets than characterizing it with universal constructions and only doing things, you know, either up to isomorphism or up to equivalence and so on and so forth. So I suppose this would be a nice read. I might get into it in the next year, and more or less recent book, and I just added here because it looks interesting. Okay, then there is this book by also an opinionated mathematician. He has an affinity to type theory. He wrote this book, Practical Foundations of Mathematics, where this is basically advertising a certain angle that makes heavy use of category theory. Although this book is not just category theory, but like has some, like, it relatively early on, you get in contact with intuitionistic type theories or set theories that are akin to some constructive frameworks like type theories. On that note, on this channel, what, 2 months ago or so, I went through a like 1 hour review of constructive set theories that might interest you if you're interested in this sort of topic. I read that a little bit too early. This was at the time I was getting into logic, and also because it has some elaborations on category theory, discusses, I don't know, adjoints and how they relate to lattice theory, and some, you know, Galois relations and so on and so forth. I find this very interesting. There's also a version of this online in like very ugly HTML, and I think the author is aware of that. It is ugly, it's almost not readable. So there is, in principle, an online version, but you best get this book from the library. I would recommend it. It's very interesting. It's not easy after the first 200 pages or so. It's quite steep. I had issues with like the characterizations of various forms of the axiom of choice in the type theoretic setting and so on and so forth. But it's opinionated, this text, and I really like that. Okay, and this is, it's about sheaves, geometry and logic. It's also a quite famous book, and it's not an introductory book to category theory as such, and it introduces topos theory to some extent, but it's also harder than most of the books in this list, I think. But nonetheless, I wanted to include it because it's a very pretty book, and it has a pretty selection of topics, and it might lure you into getting into a bunch of other topics that are related to this topos theoretical angle. Speaking of toposes, or topoi, I like to say topoi, but a lot of mathematicians also say toposes, so sometimes I might fall back to that. This is a note, so you see this is only 60 something pages that I came across actually this week, and I didn't read it because I just saw it recently, but I browsed through it and I was under the impression that this is lecture notes for my talk, and it seemed like that especially in the last third or so, it talks about the topos motivated or topos enhanced logic, but with strong back and forth between normal, let's say, logic nomenclature. So it seems easier to read than a bunch of other texts on logic, categorical logic that I read so far. And so without having read that, I think that might be, even if it's a short text, it might be quite a nice text for the logic angle to things. Then a book by Emily Riehl, she's quite known, quite famous, so I edited there, even if I have not read that also. And I think it's also maybe one of the harder books on the list. This is just a guess, basically. This is a little bit odd. I came across this some time ago, which has a very inviting title, Categorical Logic and Type Theory. It's from a guy who also seems to know his stuff. And it merges these two interesting topics and shows how they relate to each other. Also not an easy read, and also it talks a lot about fibered categories, which is not like standard in the sense that the other books would talk about it. But if you're searching for a clear description of various type theories, this book has a lot on this kind of thing. So let's quickly scan the table of content here. Like different lambda calculi, and he basically builds it up. He starts with simple types and tries to fit them in a framework described with category theory. Okay, so here you see simple type theory, and then the logics, first order, higher order, and so on and so forth. It was rough for me to understand. I didn't get all that far when I read that, but I remembered that I had some aha moments. So for that reason, it's in the list. Okay. Then I have also not read that. This is more like an essay kind of text, but I also love to read history or also some opinionated pieces on mathematics as such. So as you can see, this is more of a logic text by a logician who discusses logic and its role and interpretations. Not necessarily mathematical logic in the strictest sense. But it looks very interesting, and if somebody writes 300 pages and it doesn't look spooky, it looks like a proper text on this subject, it might be interesting for the philosophical angle to it. Okay, now we get to books that as I mentioned before, I am not sure if I recommend them because they are not written often by mathematicians for mathematicians, and so I kind of sort of get a little bit how to say this nicely, not insulted, but if you read some category theory descriptions by computer scientists who are not too mathematically minded, then it appears they tune down the concepts quite a bit, and I'm not too much of the fan of monads, arboridos, and these kind of things. So I like my very abstract characterization of what a monad is, and not the computer scientist. Everything is a bucket and approach to things. So I would not necessarily recommend these things myself, but there are a bunch of category theory for so and so, and I just add them because I don't want to make the harsh judgment. It might be that these books written for a particular type of person is better for these types of persons because they are written for them, so might well add them here. So there is Spivak, of course. I don't know how to pronounce it, but he is more known, and he has several books. And so there is one for a category theory for scientists. It might be nice. I think I remember I browsed through it, read some initial descriptions. This is similar to, in a way, to Bayes' stuff, in that he likes to motivate, has this kind of box and errors description of things, and I don't mean errors in the proper category theoretical diagrams, but basically this kind of conceptual things. It goes a little bit in the Lavier direction now that I think about it. And maybe this is also an easier introduction. If you're not used to algebra, then this might actually help. So that's why it's there. Similarly, there's this book. I'm not even sure if this is out yet. By Fong, and he also worked together with Spivak. And another introduction to category theory. There's this buzzword applied category theory going around, especially in the in the computer science corner of things, and people who do programming and translate category theoretical concepts and make use of functionality and so on. I think this is all good work, so it might sound like I'm a little bit harsh on the non-mathematicians in this video, but that's not how I wanted to come across. I think it's good, even if there are some annoying people using category theory concepts as buzzwords. If the things that I'm interested in get stronger, all power to them. Okay, then category theory for the practice and physicist. I mean, this already sounds scary. I don't know too much about it, and I think a physicist should be able to learn from a mathematician, but it might well be a good book, so here added that. Then this is basically a C++ programmer initially, and he learned category theory a few years ago and has a blog and talks about category theory, and I guess he also has YouTube videos, has this the implementation in mind. He's one of the guys who I think sees objects and morphisms as buckets and functions. So I say that with a caveat, but I imagine since he had direct feedback while he wrote it, for the people who need category theory from this kind of programming Haskell-ish, Scala-ish angle, that might help. I know people are opinionated on this and that author. I think for completeness, since it's one of the read resources right now in this corner of the web anyway, I add that as well. Yeah, similarly, but from a different sort of author, there we had these two, I think, already before. Category theory for computing science might be a different angle, but also for computing science, I guess. Well, computer science and computing science, I mean, there's also the computing science as in physics simulation. So to cover these different branches, here these recommendations, and similarly, another computer science book. Okay, so again, I think these are enough books to get started. Again, I like the first few, and you have now a broad range of books. Again, if you go to the web page of this logician, you find 20 or so more online available texts, although I think I picked out the most interesting ones of them. I would like, you know, it's always a matter of time. I would love to talk more about the algebra as I need it for physics theory building, and I'm just a big fan of framing things in terms of universal constructions. That's why I also highlighted the universal algebra book that makes that a core topic. I personally would recommend you to start learning category theory from this kind of more abstract angle. I'm mostly talking to the computer science people that I talk with a lot. But yeah, I mean, everybody has to like it. Don't hate on people who like it abstract, but also don't shoo the programmers. So with that, wish you a nice Saturday and take care.